In the top, we have, of course, the already confirmed characters. So we have Scorpion, Sub-Zero, Raiden, Melina, Kitana, Shang Tsung, Liu Kang, Kung Lao, Rain, Smoke, Kenshi, and Johnny. So those are the 12 characters. Already half the roster is already confirmed.
Okay, really quick, one thing. Since Shang is a pre-order bonus, I'd say let's make him 25, and we still have a full 24 to go. Not 24, but like a full 13 characters to go. I wouldn't include him.
That's true.
Yeah, since he's pre-order.
So then we actually have 13 characters, so one more character than what we have now to be added to this list. And we have every character, even characters that like were never appeared playable, like from the Mortal Kombat X comic book series, etc. There are some options here that seem more likely than others off rip based off the story. When we take into consideration the story, even though we know kind of little about it as of right now, we do know some key things. And some of those things have even been taken away from us, such as Rain's bio for MK1, where he had his water powers honed in by General Shao, and was actually appointed as the, Outworld's High Mage by Sindel. So with that in mind, and then also Sindel's presence in one of the stages, a good way to like set us and start us off would be characters like Shao Kahn or General Shao in this timeline, or Sindel.
They're pretty much guaranteed at this point, honestly. Like when they removed the them from Rain's bio, I was like, yeah, they have to be main roster. I don't feel that they would just be mentioned in a bio of a character that's confirmed.
Oh yeah, no, that makes sense. That makes a lot of sense, I feel. Because I didn't actually think of it that way. Like, why would they take them out if they weren't in the roster? Because I think even if they weren't main roster, it would make sense for them to be in the game, like in NPCs in the story, etc. So yeah, with that said, for now, chat, we'll be dragging General Shao Kahn, as well as Sindel into the main roster spot. That does take up two spots, right? And I think it is possible that one is playable without the other, but I would have to say, for the plot of this game, I feel like it is more likely that they both are here. We know that Kelly Hu, the voice actress for Ashra in Mortal Kombat Legends Cage Match, and she also played Devora in MKX and 11. She played Frost and Sindel in MKX as well. So when you keep that in mind, I think that Kelly Hu, which is voicing a character in MK1 that is yet to be announced, they already confirmed that. So a female character is coming soon. It is coming up with the next reveal. So for the next pick, we're gonna go with a female character. Now, who can that be? I'd have to be honest and say I think the most likely option is Ashra, because of her inclusion as voicing Ashra in Mortal Kombat Legends Cage Match, but also because Ed Boon has said, of course, that this game is going to be representing all the different eras of Mortal Kombat, and Ashra is an iconic figurehead of the female 3D era roster. But yeah, so with that said, chat, I think we can easily, I honestly feel like it's going to be Ashra. I really do. But again, we do have to also, like you said, Tsushima. It could be Sindel. It could be Sindel being revealed at the next reveal, and she could play Sindel. So who do you feel?
I feel need to be Ashra, if anybody. And the reason I say that is because it's already confirmed that she's voicing Ashra in Legends Cage Match. So that just makes the most sense. And Sindel's voice actor from 11, I feel, would carry over into MK1 because that voice actor was pretty good, honestly. Lee May, I don't feel that they'd have one person doing the voice acting for several characters. Lee May and Ashra are very different characters. So it's like one voice actor doing both characters. I feel like you wouldn't want them to have like a similar sounding voice. You know? Yeah,
no, that makes sense. I think that both characters, like you said, kind of have their own thing going on. So it would make sense for Ashra to have a different cadence and a different presentation in her voice from Lee May. It doesn't mean that Kelly Hu can't do both, because I'm sure she's talented enough to do both.
Yeah, I'm sure she can.
But
sure,
I'm sure happening. I agree. I think it would be different. Like with a chameleon, right? With like Zatera is what it's called, right? With Zatera being a thing again, do you feel like characters like Reptile or Chameleon can kind of have a spot on our main roster prediction right here?
Yeah. And not only because they have like all the realms are pretty much back. But first off, if we're talking 3D era representation, plus Reptile is one of the most popular characters, and he missed yeah. out.
I think we gotta put Reptile on the main roster. I think it's so easy.
Reptile for sure.
Yeah, at least I agree. Reptile. Yeah.
Now, I wouldn't mind female Chameleon, honestly, because I feel like Reptile has always been the only person on the roster representing like his realm, except for like Armageddon, and I don't really count that as far as like roster appearances because that was an all-in game. So I'd say yeah, they could fit in.
Who is your next one you want to shoehorn in? What is the next one you think is more like of a glaring obvious fact that could be in this game?
Well, Havoc. Go ahead, add Havoc.
Yeah, okay. I was going to say, again, chat, we know that Ed Boon has said, where is Havoc? Yeah, I forget they used that weird picture for him, didn't they? Oh, here he is.
The fourth. Okay, the fourth.
So with Ed Boon has confirmed several times before, this is going to represent the 3D era as well as every other era. So Havoc does make a lot of sense, I think.
Havoc is him, bro. Like,
I think Lee May's pretty solid to shoehorn.
Yeah, hell yeah.
I think she's a great representation for the 3D era.
I feel like she's like the second most popular 3D era female character.
Exactly. Right, so behind it makes sense. Yeah.
Ashra, however you pronounce it.
No, you're fine. Don't worry about it. But yeah, I think that's a good choice as well. And then with her, what other 3D era is there? That kind of like are obvious in a sense. I guess Tanya's more so. Oh, Nitara.
Tanya.
I was gonna say Tanya's not really 3D. She's like she was introduced in the arcade era.
Yeah, she was in MK4.
MK4. Yeah, it was her debut. Okay, so yeah, Nitara.
And then Ed Boon said that just made me think about. So okay, keep going.
Nitara, and then also who was the other character we said? I think that Tanya. Oh Tanya. Yeah. Do you think Tanya would make the base roster? I feel like she will.
Oh yeah, I think she is.
I think that's a good option. Okay, so with that in mind then, we have 20. So we only get 5 more options, right? Because Shang Tsung doesn't count as the base roster. So we only have 5 more. And we have to represent the NetherRealm era. We have to do reps from that and the arcade era.
Let's go ahead and add Reiko then. I just know, man. Ever since Ed Boon tweeted that picture of the MK4 roster, I know.
Yeah, he is that character from MK4. Like, he is the head of MK4, I think.
Yeah, exactly. Like, he's the MK4 character. Like, he's going to be in the game, which I'm not mad at. I like Reiko. A war mastermind. Like,
yeah, and I think he fits with the story. MKX
comics, bro, he definitely carried, bro.
Yeah, and he's been, obvious to be fair. Yeah, he has been obvious for sure. Do you think that Kai makes it? I really wonder if Kai would be a
for
MK4. I think he
so bad.
But I don't
bro.
Think it's. I don't know. Like I feel like I have a gut feeling he doesn't make it. But like
I feel like he'd end up being like a cameo.
Right. I think that makes more sense. I do think that he could be a good rep for MK4, but I don't see him being main roster. Okay, so with that said, what other glaring main roster choices do you think? I feel Garrus is pretty big.
Yeah, Garrus, go ahead.
Yeah, I did a whole video on it.
I used to hate Garrus, bro. I'm not gonna lie, I used to hate Garrus, but now that I like later on down the line, after like revisiting MK11's story a couple times and learning like his role,
right?
He's a really cool character, bro. I really solid. Like him. Now,
I think he has so much potential. That's the biggest thing I think, is his potential. But what do you think is next? Who do you want to go ahead and throw next? It's getting a little bit harder. It is getting harder.
Yeah. Definitely getting harder.
I think Jade. Oh well, no, maybe not Jade.
Yeah,
I'd say Jade.
We can add Jade to ours. That's where I think
she deserves to be in there.
The Countess Jade thing.
Yeah,
that's cool. First off, Jade. I love Jade anyway. Like Jade is like my third. No. Well, there's Ashra. Ashra, Lee May, then that she's top three for me.
Yeah, Jade's great. So, Jade's great. Just simply
Jade's great. But seeing the Countess Jade thing, that means bro, like she's literally a part of like the hierarchy.
Yeah.
Like royalty. Yeah.
That kind of leads like, Kodal to even be potentially a character if Kodal didn't pass away. But
yeah, maybe in this timeline, Kodal isn't an Ashtek. Maybe he could be an
Well, he'll be royalty or something regardless, but he might not be. Exactly. Yeah. Yeah, I think it's going to be huge.
Like one of the generals or something like that. I don't know. But the Countess Jade thing, like that's some pretty big, you know, that's a big title to just not be playable.
I agree. I would have to agree.
That means she has control of her own militia, own army, all type of shit. Like,
yeah, so much potential.
That's fire.
I think so. Somebody said, what was it? Oh, Nightwolf or female Nightwolf? Female Nightwolf. I think it was in one of his endings. Was it an ending? I think it was a tower ending.
Yeah, it was.
But I think what do you think about Nightwolf? Actually,
if Nightwolf comes back, I want it to be a female Nightwolf. I think it'd be sick.
I think it would be pretty cool.
Just to be on the roster of MK1 though. How many characters do we have left?
I think we have two left. Again, I think Nightwolf isn't making it. Not because I don't want him to. Nightwolf is one of my favorite characters, like in general.
Yeah,
but I just don't know if he would fit. Like maybe because all of the different realms in this game, he might. I think Nightwolf. Not only if they don't want to make him a resident of Earthrealm.
Is an Earthrealm.
No, exactly. But I'm saying if they don't want to make him, that's what I'm saying. Like if they want to do something new with this character.
Oh, okay,
they can make him be something special in Outworld or anything. I just don't know if they have enough room to flesh that out.
I don't think they'll be in the game.
Unfortunately, though, I think DLC is very unlikely for him, chat, by the way.
Like, the potential is, like, this could be, like, this overall could really be the best Mortal Kombat game.
Hard agree, brother. Hard agree. Yeah, of course. I agree.
Just off roster alone. For all we know, the roster that we see, like the slots or the 24 slots, that could just be a placeholder screen in general. Like there could be end up being 30 characters, 28, you know, we don't know for sure.
That is true. We don't know. I'm going to say to play it safe, obviously.
We have to play it safe.
Yeah. But chat, nothing's final, dude. The stress test was such an old build of the game, everything. Like, this game has so much more we have not seen. And they're doing it on purpose, Moro. They're doing it on purpose. There's so much we haven't seen.
Giving us the bare minimum so that we can... We're promoting the game ourselves by being obsessed with it. Maybe Fujin?
Honestly, I think it's probable. I think he would be a good MK4 rep, right? So, like, he still has a little bit of doubt for me, but I don't know.
Well, I'm not going to say I can't see anybody else making it, but, like... Anybody that really just catches my eye, like, that I just feel like have to be in, like, hey, I feel like we should go ahead and make the chat a little upset.
Oh, fuck, brother. No, it's time. I think that Baraka, like, it's so hit or miss. He could easily be in the game, but he also could easily not be in the game. Because, like, the Tarkov disease might just, like, eliminate him, but I don't know.
I feel like they just go back and forth between Baraka and Reptile. So if Reptile's in this game, there's a chance he won't be. So never mind.
Yeah, right. It's hard to say. Like, genuinely, we're like pretty fucking stumped for these last two options. Ermac.
Yeah.
I didn't even think about that. Ermac's got to be in there. I totally forgot.
Ermac has to be in there.
He has to be in there. Yeah. Oh my God, chat. We are so sorry. We disrespected everyone with that.
He's one of my favorite characters. Skipped right over Ermac.
He's got to be in there for sure. Ed Boon did that tweet with all the ninjas, the male ninjas, the classic ninjas. He's got to be in there. Okay, so wait. Do we have everyone now? Oh, my God.
3, 6, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Yeah.
Fuck, dude.
That's it.
That's nuts. Is there anything you think we can revise? The only decision I'm kind of iffy on, I think I'm pretty solid on all this. I think we're pretty solid. The only one I'm a little bit skeptical about is Fujin, to be honest.
I'm really just saying Fujin because, like, he carried Aftermath, bro. Him and Shang Tsung carried Aftermath.
Yeah,
man,
his character was so great.
And he still wasn't base roster on that game. So I feel like he could really... I feel like he could really... He could be main roster. I feel like he could make it. I'm kind of 75-25 on it. I kind of see why you feel... Like how you feel about Fujin.
I think it's weird because of the hierarchy of Elder Gods and shit. Like, it's different now. Like, with Liu Kang being in Raiden's place, and we don't know the potential state of the Elder Gods or the One Being and all of this stuff after the fall of Kronika. We don't really know what happened. Like, I you know what I mean? And I don't know. I'm not saying it's completely out of the door, like out the door. I think it would be cool if Raiden has a brother, like a human brother.
Yeah,
with him.
Exactly. With air powers. I think that'd be fire as fuck. See, I mean, who would you replace him with, though?
Yeah, that's kind of tough. Quan Chi, maybe? Maybe not,
yeah,
Quan Chi.
I could see that. They did say multiple villains, so I could see him
Quan
being replaced with Quan Chi.
Even Goro could be main roster, but I don't know.
See, I don't know, man. Well, wait a minute. Yeah, I could see that.
It's hard to say. Because he had that roster.
A cameo.
Well, he had that same gear that the soldier from the story mode trailer had.
Okay, yeah, put a main roster.
Yeah, do you think so? I don't know if it's that. It might be a skin.
That makes sense, though.
Because the story, right?
All of the cameo fighters
have their classic looks.
Exactly. He's the only one that does it. And he's clearly wearing the same exact, like, clothing that they were wearing, like, the Reiko-looking soldiers.
Yeah, yeah.
So that makes perfect sense. So now that you say that, I could definitely see that.
And then with that in mind, we have to eliminate... Who do you think Fujin goes?
I guess take Fujin off, man.
I don't know if I think everyone else is like solid. Like I'm so solid on everyone else. Maybe not Garrus, but I think Garrus is a good rep from the NRS era. So I think Garrus makes it. Because he's the best rep, I think, for MK11.
Yeah, is he not the only one from MK11?
Well, there's also the Collector and then Cetrion. And then the MKX ones. But I just think he's more unique.
He's the best. He's pretty much the best new addition.
Yeah, we also could take out.
I'm pretty sure Cetrion's dead if she fused into Kronika and Liu Kang killed Kronika. So I'm guessing Cetrion is just ceased to exist.
Yeah, it doesn't exist in any timeline now. Yeah, that's true. I think Goro's kind of likely, but again, we have to switch someone out for him. I'm thinking Fujin or Jade, maybe. But I think Jade's more likely.
Well,
for me. But Jade also, I don't know. Like, I genuinely don't know.
Jade, man.
I know.
Yeah, I don't know.
If it came down to me choosing, like, I could choose who's in the game, I would have to choose Jade.
I would have to choose Jade.
I would have to. Damn. Bye, Fujin. Fuck. Fuck, bro. Damn, and no Hotaru. We're talking no Hotaru, no Boraicho. Damn. There's so many people.
I wouldn't be mad if a lot of the rest of these people be cameos.
Exactly, yeah. We can go ahead and spitball a cameo roster quickly if you want to. Who do you think is like most likely cameos? Oh, damn, we didn't even add Quan Chi. Although, I don't know. He could miss. I think he could definitely miss a main roster.
I feel like he'd be like a DLC.
He could be DLC, yeah, for sure. Okay, so yeah, do you want to put Quan Chi DLC? I think that's a huge move, I think.
Yeah, you can put him on DLC.
Who do you think are like the most likely cameos we haven't seen yet?
I'd say go ahead and throw Shujinko on cameos.
You think so? Oh, bro, I'd cry. I really hope he's in this game.
I hope so. As far as 3D era representation, he was literally the main character.
Yeah, true.
Of the game.
Yeah, of the story at that time.
They could at least make him a cameo. At least.
So for the cameos chat, I just want to make this clear in case anyone's screenshotting this and like flaming us on Twitter or something. Just keep in mind that the cameo fighters, we're not adding any of the ones that are already confirmed to this point, because that way we don't waste like squares of people. So any of the ones that are already confirmed to be in the game, like, and they're going to be like a duplicate. So for example, Kung Lao has two, Scorpion has one, like that type of shit for cameos. We're not going to include any of the confirmed ones. We're only doing ones that are not confirmed. Takeda, I think Takeda, I'm going to put Takeda for now. And then we also have...
I think Takeda will be DLC.
Oh, you think so? Not even a cameo character? DLC character?
I think he'll be DLC because you gotta realize.
Even with Kenshi. That's fair.
Like, he's damn near the best one to me.
I'll put Motaro on there. I think Motaro was pretty gonna be a cameo. I think Shinnok could make a good cameo.
Yeah, with the bone powers.
Yeah, I think it could be a cool cameo, yeah. I'm not thinking, well, maybe if he's not in the main roster cameos, I think for sure he's a DLC cameo. I don't know though. I don't know. I want to put ones where we actually are predicting. So, like, I don't want to just throw shit out there, you know? I'm trying to, like, full-on predict something.
I could see him being a cameo.
You think so? You think, like, you feel it in your gut? In your gut? Well,
okay,
Sir JD,
okay,
do you
okay.
feel it in your
then
gut?
Then again, no, I don't.
Exactly.
I don't think he'll be in the game at all.
Yeah, that's realistic. Fair. I like the idea of the bone powers being a cameo, but I just don't see it happening. I think there's a lot of 3D era characters that can make cameos. Draman cameo, I think for sure.
Yeah, Draman.
I think Serena. Where's Serena?
Next to Shinnok.
Next to Shinnok. Yeah, Serena, I think that's pretty good. I don't know. What do you think about Serena cameo?
Yeah, I like Serena. Serena could definitely be a cameo. At least a cameo.
Yeah, I'd agree. I think Serena is a good cameo. I think Devorah is very likely for a cameo. Cabal too. Those are pretty big ones. What about Chameleon cameo?
Yeah, definitely.
I kind of like Blaze more than Shinnok, someone said in chat. Honestly, not a bad take. I can't even lie. Shinnok is kind of lame from time to time. Most times, I'd say. I like Corrupted Shinnok. He's cool. Yeah, I wasn't going to bring it up, but you had to, brother. Oh, no. Yeah, Cassie did put in the work against Shinnok, which is a little bit embarrassing.
That made no sense. Like, that just messed up the entire power scaling.
Well,
like,
I guess the god power or the god killer, whatever the fuck, you know, the powers or whatever.
Man, they used that. That's plot armor at its finest.
That's fair. Then again, we're Cole Young fans. I don't know if we can speak.
You're right. Maybe shut the hell up.
Oh, dude, I would love if Cole Young would be DLC, brother. Chat, I said it. I said it and I'm proud. I said it. I think Cole Young DLC would be cool. It's not going to happen, though. It's not going to happen.
Yeah, it's definitely not going to happen, but I would be mad at it.
I don't know. I wouldn't be mad at that. I think he could be cool in the game. Do you think mocap cameo? Don't say,
are you serious, Cole Young? Like, leave Cole Young alone.
Cole Young's
fine. Spell his last name.
And especially if they, yeah, that's true. Especially if they get Louis Tan to do like the face model and shit. I think it would just be a really cool cameo to have. Or even a character in DLC, but I just don't think it will happen.
I don't want him to be a part of the story at all. Like,
oh, of course not. It wouldn't. It wouldn't work, and it would overwrite his movie plot, which would be kind of weird.
People just overhate Cole Young. I'd rather have Cole Young over Shinnok.
Okay, is it bad that I agree with that? Is it bad that I agree with that?
That's fine.
I'd rather have Cole Young than Kano, if that makes anyone more mad. I'd much rather have Kira than Kano. Yeah, I'd much rather have Kira than Kano. Yeah. So who else do you think is like a very solid cameo that we haven't added yet? Who do you think is like, yeah, I think that they're a good cameo?
Aaron Black.
Yeah, Aaron Black is a good one. Where is he at? Yeah. Oh, also Baraka cameo makes sense, I think.
Yeah, I can see a Baraka cameo.
I don't know what I feel though.
I'm really trying to think about like what they do as a cameo. Like, I can definitely see Aaron as a cameo because basically make every character some form of a zoner.
For sure. Someone said Moloch cameo. That's true.
I don't think Ed Boon would give us Drummond and Moloch.
Oh, that's true, like, actually. Realistic. Yeah, we got Drummond. That kind of represents the Onis. Yeah, I'd agree.
General Tier said a Hotaro cameo. I can see that.
Yeah, actually, that's a good one. I think, do you feel, yeah, actually, I think
yeah, I can see that.
A Tremor too, by the way. I think I saw someone say that. I just remember.
Oh, hell yeah. I forgot all about Tremor.
I think Cabal would be a good cameo to like run across the screen really quickly. You know, and like hurt you. I don't know.
Oh, hell yeah. Yeah.
I think it makes sense. He's also a fan favorite.
I feel like he do like the chain, like the, not the chain, but like the spike, the thing that goes across the floor.
Yeah. It'd be sick, right? Oh my God, that'd be kind of sick.
Yeah, hell yeah. That'd be fire.
This was fun. Again, we kind of wanted to stay within the logistics of the story, the logistics of like what NRS would do, all of that kind of stuff. So that was really fun. I appreciate you guys for chatting with me and always supporting me. You guys are the best. I want to say thank you to JD for being here, of course.
For sure.
It's always a pleasure to speak with you,
this
man.
This will not be my last time being around, guys.
Yeah, that is true. That is true. We're working on some other things. We're cooking some other stuff up. Let me lab for a bit, JD. Yeah, dude, they all want to lab you, bro. You gotta live up to the potential, bro.